Are you looking for a really accessible digital way to journal? If so, Google Docs might be the solution for you. In this video, I want to show you how you can set up Google Docs to be effective as a diary or a journal and provide you with a template that you can take. So stay tuned, we're going to jump into that. And at the end, I will share the template that you can use to make this setup much quicker. Hey, I'm Adam with Productivity Academy, and like I said, we're going to talk about using Google Docs as a journal or diary, as well as kind of creating a template. And at the end, I'll give you the link so you can use this, what we're going to create right now. But want to talk to you briefly about Google Docs, maybe why you might want to be using this, or perhaps what might be most appealing to you. If you are not familiar with Google Docs, it is free. If you have a Gmail or a Google account, you can access it. One of the easiest ways is to just type into the URL toolbar. You can just say doc.new, and that will just open up a new one if you're not making a copy of this or you want to do anything else. Otherwise, I will assume that you have some familiarity with Google Docs and that you have used this before. Again, if not, you can just do a quick search and come up to date with that and create your account. But once you come in, it's a very simple, in most senses, word editor that you're probably familiar with. It's an excellent tool for some types of journaling. Assuming you want to be doing digital journaling, this is great. Google is very interoperable with a lot of different systems. If you want to add automation to it, if you want to share it places, you know, if you want to use it with Google Calendar as setting up a reminder system for yourself, there's a lot of pros to this. Some cons that, you know, some downsides to this may be if you want to maybe have your information locally, that could be a problem. This is on the cloud, as well as maybe digital journaling won't work out for you. Some people really like writing, but I'm going to skip that and just say if you're here, you probably want to give this a shot. So let's talk about setting up the journal. So what we want to do is make use of the features that Google Docs and Google has provided. So what we can do here is we see over here on the side, we have headings. It says you add to the document will appear here. And this is a great way to do this. So what we could do is instead of maybe having every single day, we could break it down by week or by month, however you want to do it. For me, I think I'll just call it you know, week one, week two, week three, things like that. This could be the year if you're starting in January. You could organize this a bunch of different ways, but I'm just going to call it week and maybe it starts on Monday. So let's just call it week one. And then we're going to highlight that and I'm going to give it a heading two. And we now see that it pops up there. All right, this is going to be really nice because what we can also do, and there's two ways you can do this. You could put a day in here. So let's do that. Let's put date. So like that would be today's date. I'm recording this on the 6th of November. So let's leave that. And then I'm just going to put in the entry and we can then type some things in here, put whatever we want. And then we could have the next date be 7 November. Okay. So this is literally all we need to do. Pretty simple. That gets you started and off to the races. I think that, you know, the bare minimum you're going to want to track is the date and your entry. You know, you may not even need to have entry. You could just start typing. I think that that helps though, and it helps break it up and you keep track and have some separation and you know at least what date you wrote it instead of what week. The other thing you could do here is, you know, have week one and put the date. So we could say like 6 November to 13 November. And then you could maybe get rid of the dates and just have entries and you would know what week. But I think for most people, you would want to keep track down to the day and we will do it that way. Now let's see what happens when we go down here. Let's say we've done a whole week and we go in and we do week two. Then we see that showing up here. If you want it to be reverse chronological in the sense of most recent first, you're going to want to put this above it, which may or may not be confusing. All right, so week two now appears above and you then push it down, which is probably what you want to do. So then we would have date and that looks like it's formatting weird. So let me just do that and entry. So that formatted as a heading and we want to do normal text. And I kind of like that better. So We're going to go with that. And I'm actually going to fancy this up a little bit. And I like having some dividers so that we can see, you know, more clearly what each day is. So I'm gonna go all the way over and we're gonna get that out there. And now we have kind of a daily template, and I could do 7 of these. I'll do 5. I think most people don't journal every single day. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And now we could copy that out, and you could just come in here. And what you might wanna do is keep a template. So I would actually put it down here and we would just call it week X. And then you could always come in when you're starting a new week. So let's say, for example, we've got 50 weeks in here and we're starting week 51. All you have to do is click down to week X, copy that, come back up here, hit enter, paste it, week 51, and there you go. So that covers the really basics about using this as a journaling app of just putting down information. Now, let's take things a little bit further. I would say one of the most important parts about journaling is consistency, right? If you do it once every 3 months, probably not as effective. So what you might want to do is grab the URL, either click over here on share, grab it from your toolbar, copy that and put that into something you have. Hopefully you have some sort of a reminder, maybe a morning process you go through. So copy and paste that into that one area, whether it's Google Calendar, whether it's Todoist, whether it's ClickUp, whatever you're using. Hopefully you have something in place so that you can have everything centralized and not have to remember, oh, I need to go into this folder and then click here and then open this. Makes it much easier, much more likely that you'll build consistency and keep up the journaling habit. So what else could we do? Well, you could add some things. For example, let's say we're writing out our entries. We've got some other things. You could add, maybe you want to go back and you bold the really important parts after you've read it, right? It's the idea of kind of going back and reviewing and marking what's really important. Maybe you could add things in like, how do I feel today? That could be an important prompt and just something to get you started. And speaking of journal prompts, I'll put the link in now. If you want to have some journaling prompts to help you get started or find out more about journaling prompts, those can be a great way to get started, and I can provide you more of those for free if you click on the link above. But you know, beyond just how you feel, maybe what am I grateful for today? You could have maybe a mood tracker and track it with emojis if you like the color, if you like something other than just raw text. That can be really helpful. And what you can also do, and what I highly recommend doing, is this now makes it really easy. Maybe every 4 weeks, every 12 weeks, right? So every month or 3 months, you do a review. And this being kept chronologically means that you can go back and quickly see what's going on. Or if you wanted to even use some tools to do like maybe word analysis, like what keeps being repeated, like a word cloud, or what's going on, what's the repeated entries, that makes it much easier because you already have it digitized. You could copy and paste this stuff in, maybe just remove date and entry and clean things up. And you're on your way to getting a lot of really valuable information out of the time and information you put into your journaling. So on top of Google, there are a lot of other options you could be using. I think Google Docs is a decent digital option, and it allows you, of course, to be portable in the sense that it can be used almost anywhere. You can use it on a desktop, on a laptop, on your phone, tablet, whatever it might be, and it's going to work well. So I think that that's a really good option if you're looking for it. Some others that you might consider would be Notion. You know, the ability for Notion to have databases and some better organization, I feel that could be nice. A little bit more of the multimedia experience, although in Google Docs, you can certainly paste or add images, things like that. And then there's other tools too, you know, Obsidian, Rome Research, lots of others that have text editors that you can do some organizing with and keep track. So I think it's really, like all journaling, it's finding out what works for you. But with Google Docs for a journal or a diary, adding some structure to it in the sense of keeping track of dates over time and helping yourself be consistent is the big idea. And then if it works for you, great. Adapt it, make it yours. If not, that's fine too. Go on, try something else. So I appreciate you watching. If you want to download the free journaling prompts, you can go to productivity.academy/journaling prompts, and that link will be up above, and I'll include it in the description below. Also, I have the link to this template. I will clean this up and remove the gibberish here, and you can grab that as a starting point so you don't have to go in and enter all this stuff, and then make sure you start using it and customizing it. If you have any questions, comments, leave it below. I'd be happy to get back to you. Thanks for watching.